Yeah. All right, let's head back to Candlekeep then. Not Candlekeep. Friendly Arm Inn. I'm trying to help this guy. Been a while since we were there. I'm gonna save first. Undoubtedly, we're gonna experience problems on the road. The further you go,
you have been waylaid by enemies and must defend yourself.
Just regular wolves.
Go for the eyes! Go for the eyes! Squeaky wheel gets the kick!
And so do wolves, apparently.
Full plate and packing steel.
We made it. This guy's not dead, is he? So why couldn't we go to another temple? We have to specifically go to the temple here. I believe it's on this side. Oh, she might be selling some healing spells. I actually forgot all about her. Well, this is the inn itself, isn't it? Yeah.
Must rest. I have a bad case of armor change.
We'll rest here.
Ooh, I'm tired.
Alright. Galana Mirrorshade. Hi.
Squeaky wheel gets the kick!
It would seem that you have someone among you who is badly injured. Is there something I could do for them? This man is named Samuel. We were told to bring him to you. Oh dear. It is Samuel. What bad shape he is in. I am glad you have brought him to me. Such a fine young man. It's a pity he let himself be persuaded by Lena to desert the fist. Well, nothing can be done about that. But something can be done about his health. For the service that you have provided, I want you to have some potions as a show of my gratitude. Oh yeah, healing potions, please.
Good on you if you saved the
potion
day.
Of heroism, elixir of health. Wouldn't have been my first choice. As Lena asked, we brought Samuel to the Temple of Wisdom and turned him over to Galana Mirrorshade. Alright. So my reputation increased. Huh.
Camaraderie, adventure, and steel on steel. The stuff of legend, right, Boo?
Squeak! Okay, so this is that one that cures poison and disease and heals 10 hit points. A potion of heroism. Hit points plus 10%. That goes set to 90% of current base. Potion is imbued with a powerful enchantment that will simulate a temporary increase in level. Effect lasts for 2 hours, which makes this potion a powerful ally in a deadly combat. May only be used by warriors.
Glittergold, guide your eye on your travels.
Potions of healing. Chaotic commands? Wow, level 5. Visual range of the characters. Chaos sphere. Chaotic commands renders a creature immune to magical commands. Suggestion, charm, domination, command, sleep, and confusion are all spells that fit into this category. The spell affects only one creature and lasts for the duration or until dispelled. Okay, so it's a buff against, yeah, these things. Very high level. Don't need it. Not yet, anyway. I wonder if you should get some more healing potions. Yeah, I guess so. Pretty cheap here. Plenty of healing to go around.
Your point. Aye, squeaky wheel gets the kick.
No punching right
butt
now.
Butt kicking for goodness.
It was stuck. I guess we could identify this stuff now.
You must gather your party before venturing forth.
Khalid and Jahira might be here.
Squeaky wheel gets the kick.
Onir is here. I don't see Khalid and Jahira.
I need some help.
Alright. How many things do I need to identify? One, two, three, four, five. All right.
Such menial tasks.
Seek yourselves whatever you
see. Be time.
Simple matter.
All right, let's see what we have. Protection from magic. Okay, so it's not a special anti people who kill my parents. It's a protection from magic. Invokes a very powerful invisible globe of anti-magic in a 3-foot radius from the user. No form of magic can pass into or out of it, but physical matter is not hindered. This will remove spell effects that the caster is currently under. This effect is not permanent and will wear off within 2 hours. Spells cannot be cast from the inside or to the outside of the globe. All magical effects affecting the user are dispelled. Now, I think magical items that you have will still work. So this isn't even... Yes, I can't write the spell. It's not a spell, per se. It's just a... Oh, I didn't have to do this. Ring of Fire Resistance. This is the one we found in that little nook. Okay, the Grand Mage Batalista intended this item to aid in his travels in the Plane of Fire, and it is said he repeatedly summoned a salamander from that realm to aid in the construction. Salamanders not being known for their patience, it is likely he should not have pestered his instructor quite so much. The finger bearing the finished ring was indeed untouched by the inferno that claimed his tower. Had that finger still been attached, Batista himself might have fared better. Now, of course, the salamanders they mention here are not at all like salamanders we know. The little lizard-type things who, like, hang out in water and such. Actually, I think they might be amphibians. But, yeah, they're fire lizard amphibian things. Fire resistance plus 40%. Well, that's cool. Someone can use that. Yeah. Emmowyn has it. A wand of monster summoning. Sweet! I've yet to play with any of the monster summon monsters thing spells. This wand will summon 12 HD of monsters which appear within the area of effect and attack the user's enemies. They remain until the spell duration expires or the monsters are slain. These creatures vanish when slain. No opponent exists to fight and the wizard can communicate with them. The summoned monsters can perform other services for the summoning wizard. 12 HD of monsters. I don't know. I wonder if you can communicate with them. Arrows plus 2. Pretty much the same description as the arrow plus 1. I just have her hold on to them. Okay, magical chainmail. Oh, chainmail plus one, that's all it is. Alright. Armor class 4. It's not going to be as good as the plate mail, the normal plate mail, is it? Armor class 3, yeah. And she has 3 as well. Alright, So we'll sell that, obviously. Oh, I'll just change our spells back. Rune keg shell. He will not buy it. He will buy the chainmail plus one, so hey. Take it. Yeah, sell all this crap. Not bad, almost 2,000 gold. Oh, bluestone necklace. And here's a silver necklace. Or a few of them. You won't buy the darts.
I need some ale.
Less squeaky wheel gets the kick.
Oh wait, we need to rest again and change our spells back. Sure, that's where I had it. So I have Resist Fear and Stinking Cloud. Yeah. All right, resting.
My inn is open to all who behave themselves.
Oh. One thing. All right, let's get out of here.
Kuvarsam.
I want to take this Ankh-Egg head to Thunderhammers and see if we can do something with it. I'm looking for the exit here.
Yes?
Yes?
Full plate and packing steel.
We'll go our separate ways. Oh no, they're gonna meet up with us. Thought there was only one way out of here. Just wasn't sure which way it was, so I figured they could lead us. Back to Baraghost.
full plate and packing steel.
I'm paused. Wait. Here we go.
Full plate and packing steel.
Oh, I thought so. An interesting piece of material got there. And keg, if I'm not mistaken. Been a while since I've seen a like, but if I remember correctly, it makes a fine set of armor. If properly treated, it's comparable to full plate with half the weight. If you're willing to part with your shells, I'll give you 500 gold for the lot of them. No more can I offer with business as slow as it is. Iron shortage hurting us all. I thought he could make Onkeg armor and we could buy it. Hardly a fair price for the trouble I went through to get it. Double your offer and consider it done. Whoa, iron is not so scarce as to make me that desperate. 500 gold or nothing, and you can take it or leave it. I suppose I will take it. You know what, though? I don't even have it memorized. I'll take it. This will make a fine suit of plate for governor or better. Nobility like exotic materials and don't care much about the price. Probably close to 20,000 gold for 10 days' work when I'm finished. I may survive this iron shortage after all. Ugh. One lousy Onkeg. What does it say? Gibberling hordes. Oh, it's done. These are done quests. Jared and the bear. Oh, yeah. One lousy Onkeg shell for 500 gold? I can't believe everyone isn't out hunting those giant bug monsters. I wonder.
Squeaky wheel gets the kick!
If the other one is still out there. Got a lot of gold, nice. Let's try going back.
Butt kicking for goodness.
Wait, do I have...
Butt kicking for goodness.
Hold up. Just making sure we don't have anything else heavy to sell, not really.
Squeaky wheel gets the kick!
It's this one, right?
Butt kicking for goodness!
Alright, let's see if we can find those Onkeg heads. They might be gone, but... just in case they're not. I think it was around here that we fought the first group of them. And the others are either around here or through here. Not sure. I tend to think... higher. More northern, anyway. They might have decayed away. Oh, look, I am clearing some of this. Oh, there we go. There's a tiny bit left, but that's pretty good. Seeing any of them. There's around here somewhere that we've encountered Samuel and Lena, I think. And we had to drop one of them? Yeah, it must be gone. Oh well. It's so heavy. What if we carry it, you know? Once we picked up Samuel's body, that was it. We had to drop one. Regrettable. Oh, gibbling. A Jasper gem.
And steel on steel. The stuff of legend, right, Boo?
Less talk, more fighting.
Name.
Or whatever he says. Yeah, we're not staying here. Gladly go sell some more. And then what I was planning when I was mentioning that I don't have that spell memorized, I was going to cast Friends on myself to give myself a higher charisma and try to talk him into a higher price. Well, maybe next time if we find more Ankh eggs.
And packing steel. Full plate and packing steel.
Let's just get rested up.
You want some whiskey?
Wait, I quit out. I tend to click done just instead of rent. Is he selling anything good? I need a magical battle axe. You know what's his name? The Thunderhammers might be selling some. Or one. It's just I didn't have that much money. I want to wear the Ankh egg armor.
Squeaky wheel, oh. Get the kick.
It's late. Maybe he'll be offering it now. It's 5 a.m. Let's just rest.
Full plate and packing steel.
Okay, back to Thunderhammers. Squeaky
wheel gets the kick.
This group shows promise exceptional.
exceptional. I like the way she says that.
Butt kicking for goodness!
Exceptional. Well, he sells it for 20,000. Damn, this guy. I wish he'd just make it for us. Oh, these are throwing axes. Oh, here, buy this. Buy these gems. He won't buy the darts. Yeah, we'll totally buy the cursed berserking sword. Quality battle axe. Does that mean it won't break quality? I'd rather get a magical one if we could afford it. Balax plus one. That's a halberd. All right, sold. What about this protector of the second? Armor class 6. I wonder if she could use it, Imowen. She might have better than an armor class already. Well, she has studded leather armor plus one. Oh, it's the same. Oh, it's even better. Even better versus armor class 6 and the other one's 8 versus something, and this is 4 and 5 versus stuff. Mm. There you go, Kagin. Sweet. And he's proficient in that as well. He better be. Axe? I'm guessing battle axe counts as axe. Why wouldn't it, right? Proficiency type, axe. There you go. So he can really slaughter with this. Back to the slaughtering. I forgot. But your non-magical stuff breaks after time.
You point, I punch.
Do we need any bullets or anything like that? I guess a stack each would do.
Full plate and packing steel.
There's 80. That should be another 80. There we go. We are prepared as much as we can be for anything that awaits us.
Squeaky wheel gets the kick! Butt kicking for goodness!
So I'm not completely sure where we're going next. I know I could just hit map, but... there's a bandit camp there. Huh. Didn't see that before. Now that we have this past a friendly arm, that might be advancing the main quest. We have this over here. I might just hit this. Next. See what's there. According to my trusty map, that is Peldvale. No, not Peldvale. Mutamin's Garden. And this. That's a fishing village, I believe. And that's near Baldur's Gate. Interesting. A bandit camp, I see. Alright. We might check out Mutamin's Garden, see if it doesn't kick our butt too much. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time, and always seek adventure.